Hi, I'm Jacinda from the customer success team here at Mouseflow, and I'm here today to show you our favorite tip and trick that we like to show our enterprise clients when we do their onboarding. Let's begin. So we're going to go ahead and start with just kind of a blank new journey, and we're going to use a landing page example. However, this trick can work for a variety of different use cases, situations, but this is just the most common one that we'll see. So if we want to analyze how well a landing page is performing, we can definitely go ahead and just set it in here within our focus. So I'm going to go ahead and click apply, and I'm going to use one of our case studies that we did with our customers and that we had it as a landing page. So right away, I went ahead and I kind of applied it here, and I can just see overall, okay, well, what do users do after navigating with this? However, if you want to see, okay, for users that are just seeing this is the very first page, they aren't ending up on this maybe by just going through our site, maybe we have an element that would lead them to this page here, which is our case. So what we want to do is we're going to go ahead and add an entry page filter. So this way we're capturing users where this, we know for a fact this was the very first touch point that they had on our website. And this can also work for signup flows, like an insurance funnel too. And you don't have to add an entry page filter as well. If you have any UTM parameters, it would also work for this too. And so now that we've gone ahead and added it here, and then I hover over the focus step, I can see, wow, that's a lot of Dropbox. So what I would do as my next step is, okay, I want to know why exactly are people dropping off here? And if I click on the focus step, I can go straight away to the heat map. And from the heat map, I can look up a scroll heat map to see what the average scroll rate is. Are people seeing all the information? Is the page a little too long? Or I can look at the attention heat map to see where exactly people are spending the most amount of attention or the least. And then I can go from there to see what I need to do to maybe improve this, if I need to change the style, if maybe I need to put less information, or I need to do maybe more CTAs kind of at the very top. We're going to go ahead and save this. And we want to save this that way we can access it as a widget within the dashboard, and we can always have it there. And then we don't have to go through the process of creating it again and again. So we'll go ahead and save it here. And then we're going to do another common use case that we'll see. So I'm going to go ahead and create a new journey. And let's just do our home page here. Now, we always recommend that it's good to just have one journey being your home page. That way you can get an explorative view of, you know, what customers do after interacting with the home page. Now I want to see how many people are experiencing click rage. Is there a common journey? You can also use our 404 friction event, which is another one that we usually recommend. Today, I won't be showing that. But when you do the 404 friction event, you'll be able to see what the most common journey is for users who do encounter this. And this way, it can help you find and fix any broken links that are leaving people here, maybe old product pages, old Black Friday landing pages that shouldn't be there. So I'm going to go ahead and just do the click rage one to see if there's any sort of pattern with users having click rage. And this is just going to filter through all of it. And I can see right away, okay, so it's pretty common for people who have some kind of click rage where they go through the signup page, then back to the home page pricing. And if you notice that they're going back and forth between maybe two URLs, something could be broken. So from what my next steps would be to use the session replay and also the heat maps and apply this filter there. And we're going to go ahead and save it. Well, I hope you enjoyed our tips and tricks. If you're interested in learning more, please contact support@mouseflow.com. Or if you're interested in working with a customer success team to help you get the most value out of Mouseflow, you can also contact us at support@mouseflow.com. Thank you.